Welcome to this week's episode of
Disney Family Nerds.
We are going to be doing our top five favorite character meet and greets. Should we get started?
Let's clarify meet and greet, right? It's somebody that we've already met, you know, a character that we've had the opportunity to take pictures with.
Interact with
a little bit, for sure. You know, not a passing by. Like, we were able to follow Peter Pan one time, but
he followed us.
We've never really had a chance to meet him. And then it's not, you know, characters we want to meet. This is going to be characters that we have met and we enjoyed the
meeting
most.
Meeting them. So, yeah.
But yeah, definitely. Let's go ahead and get started. So.
All right, ready?
Ready?
Kidney? Number
five.
Oh, yeah, sorry. Oh, my goodness.
Whoa. All right, no, we're good.
Ta-da. All right, let's try this again.
We're going to go number five.
All right, Kinley, number five. Magnificent Minnie. Speak up a little bit louder.
Magnificent Minnie. Again, pronunciation with us is like not the best thing we do. So let's just go with the Minnie at the big top.
Yeah. Why'd you like that Minnie?
He's like meeting her.
That's good. And she was really sweet.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Aspen.
Number five.
Moana.
All right.
It was fun to meet her because do you like Pua better or Hey Hey? Is he like, I like them in their... I like them both in their own ways. She didn't say which one she likes better.
She likes Hey Hey better.
I'm just going to say this because these two fight about it all the time. Who's better, Hey or
Pua?
Only one of them has an ice cream in Disney World, and that's Hey Hey.
Bam!
Comment down below, who do you think is better, Pua or Hey Hey?
And to go with the Moana thing, she was only out during the Christmas party. So it's a cool one of those extra characters.
Yeah, that was fun to see her then. For sure. And she was over by the Tiki Room. So that's kind of
neat.
In the Tiki Room. In the birds and words and the flowers room. In the Tiki Room.
Yeah, we get to listen to that a lot. So, but it's all good. It's all good. So, all right, Mommy. Mommy, number five.
I put Stitch. He was the very, very first character me and Travis met on our Disney moon.
Yep.
He was at Animal Kingdom back then.
Yep.
Like, we literally were just walking by, and he was right there, and I, like, freaked out.
Yep.
Because he was my favorite character.
Yeah, she's got tattooed and everything, so.
Yeah, I'm like, oh my god, he goes, go get an autograph book.
Yep, so it was a quick dash to get an autograph book, and then she got in line, I got the book, we met up in line, and then, yeah, it was.
And then I married Stitch.
Yeah, they did a whole marrying thing.
The character handle married me and Stitch and kind of pushed you out of the way.
So I was waiting for alimony and all that, but I haven't gotten anything yet.
Yeah, so that's a fun Disney movie. Because we just got married, so Stitch thought that was kind of cool. So then me and Stitch got married because he's my favorite. Oh my god, I'm so excited.
Yeah, Stitch was always a lot of fun. And I'm just going to jump in here. That's my number five, too. My number five was Stitch as well. So
you were mad because I married him.
I was, but how fun was that?
You bought her like a stuffed animal this big.
I did. On our Disney moon, I ended up buying her a huge Stitch stuffed animal.
But he had it shipped home, so I didn't know about it.
Right,
so
it was a surprise. And
yeah, it was really awesome. A couple days after our Disney moon, like, we got back, we were both having the blues, the Disney blues, which comes along after leaving. And I was like, this big package from Disney World. Oh my god, it was like the best thing. I had the biggest grin.
Yeah, it was a lot of fun.
Very sweet of him.
Yeah, so the whole thing, though, Stitch was, it was a great character, it was a great interaction, I enjoyed it. So also my number five. So.
Awesome. Ba-la-la.
Ba-la-la.
All right.
Let's go get
our dino. All right, number four. All right, Kinley, you're number four.
I'm covering my list.
Oh, no. All right, Anna and Elsa.
Anna and Elsa.
All right.
We put them together because kind of... they're in the same area, next to each other.
You meet them.
And they're sisters. They're kind of like one.
Yeah.
So, what did you like meeting Anna and Elsa? We met them a couple times.
Mm-hmm.
I like Elsa's frozen powder and like them getting together.
Yeah, they're fun. The first time we met them, they were over at the Princess Hall.
Yep.
In Magic Kingdom. And then...
They're still in MK.
No, they remember over in Norway now? Yeah. By their ride? Yeah. In Norway, so...
No, that was Olaf.
No, Olaf is at Hollywood.
Yeah.
Oh. Hey, guys. We're back. Sorry about that. Our battery died.
Mm-hmm.
So, I think we left off with Aspen's number 4.
BB-8.
Nice. How come we like BB-8?
It was, like, always fun because you were, like... She just defeated Darth Vader and he, like... Yeah, like, don't worry, I defeated him.
Right, then he kind of got all happy.
Yeah.
Then, yeah, like I said, then we're leaving, we all did our thumbs up picture with him. Because, you know, in the movie, he does his little lighter flip, thumbs up with Finn.
Also yeah. Cool.
Yeah, very cool. Yeah, definitely good interaction one.
Yeah, I like that's a good one.
Yeah.
My, your number 4.
Yeah, what's number 4 for
all
you,
all right, my number 4 is the Great Goofini. Another big top circus one.
Yep, there we go.
He was a good one to interact with. He always... He's very personal. He got Kinley not to be shy. He went up to her and got her, and you know, and she came in and started interacting with him. He's fun. And again, I think I made Aspen jealous. I got a kiss from him. So,
you know, she's got a crush.
Yeah, a little bit of crush on Goofy. So, yeah, the Great Goofini. I mean, he's always a fun one to interact. Those big top circus ones usually are. So
I didn't
good.
Get my Goofy stuffed animal like I was supposed to.
Oh, it's okay. You got a hat, though.
Yeah, the one thing I'll say about that whole big top circus group, the lines are not terrible.
No, they're not bad at all.
You're not waiting a long time to go and see all of them.
Maybe the longest wait was 15 minutes, and that was for Minnie and Daisy.
Yeah, not bad at all.
No,
we should have went back inside the boys because they had like one person in a while.
Yeah, we should have gone back in it again.
Their lines were not long.
They weren't. All right, Daddy, your number 4.
All right, my number 4, I had it written down as the whole Big Top group. I was going to combine them, but I, you know what? I changed my mind completely, so scratch number 4. Number 4 for me now is Wreck-It Ralph and Vanellope.
Oh, good one.
I'm really digging their costumes. I mean, they're awesome. Wreck-It Ralph's hands are legit huge and hard. Like, he could literally wreck something.
Right. Fist bump them.
Yeah. And he wrecked our hands.
Yeah.
But,
Wreck-It.
No, so it's, again, attention to the detail. I'm a details guy. Their costumes are amazing. Really cool. We saw them before they were coming out of that tunnel. So now that they're coming out of that tunnel, it's even cooler, like coming out of the internet, Wi-Fi kind of thing.
Yeah, we saw them in their innovations,
maybe? Yeah, they were in innovations, I think, was
like, everybody was in line just to see Ralph and Vanellope was still out.
Yeah,
it was, that's so, just it, Vanellope
like, everyone went to the sideline, and then Vanellope was like, doop, doop, doop.
All right, I'll leave. So she left, and then like 5 minutes later, she came back with Ralph.
Yep.
And then...
Everybody's like, yay!
Yeah, everyone's clapping.
So that's my number 4.
Awesome. All right. Number three.
Kinley, who's your number 3?
Speak up, girly girl.
Ariel.
Good one. Why do you like me and Ariel? Because you like her.
I like her tail and I like swimming.
You like her tail? You like swimming? Good one. She's always very nice.
Yeah, so always very nice.
The grotto though, the cool place
and
to go.
And she's always under the sea.
Yeah, you have to go
under
the grotto.
Under the sea.
All right. Aspen, number 3.
Aurora.
Aurora, nice. How come?
You're a copycat.
Okay.
She was always very sweet. She always had, like, that nice voice, the calm voice. Mm-hmm. And I really thought it was fun meeting her.
Cool.
All right. Mommy, what is your number 3?
My number 3 is the Astounding Donald Duck. Another big top circus guy.
Big top circus.
This one, of course, I had more fun with. Daddy, he's okay with it, but Donald's always been my favorite, like, growing up. So Donald tried to shoo. Daddy had the picture, and then we turned around. We signed it, and then we did a little butt wiggle dance with his tail. And so, yeah, no, he's good. Like I said, he was another one that I like. Donald's always a fun character, too.
I thought for sure it would have been Mexican Donald.
Mexican Donald's fun, but he doesn't do as much more dancing as me then. Maybe just the wrong time when we go meet Mexican Donald.
Yeah.
But the Astounding Donald I've always had more fun with.
That's fair enough.
Yeah. All right, Daddy, number 3. All
right. My number 3 is Kylo Ren.
Ooh.
I know, right? Kind of weird.
That's
different.
A good one, right?
But I just the atmosphere. You know how you get even the caretakers or whatever they are, you know, getting into it. Like, yeah, Aspen was trying to do the whole, because she mastered the Jedi training. And they like, oh no, you can't use the Force on the Supreme Leader, blah, blah, blah. But the way they interact.
But I showed him the pin light. Yeah. I'm a Jedi dude.
Yep. So their interactions, you know, how they actually like get into the character, get into the role. I appreciate that. So that's my number three.
Yeah, that was good. Come on. All right, number two.
What do you got, Kinley?
Kinley, we got for number two.
You copycat.
He's not copying.
Wreck-It Ralph.
How come you like Wreck-It Ralph and Vanellope? You like them? You like the movie?
And I like meeting them.
And you like meeting them? Yeah, they're always fun. Mm-hmm. Good one. Mm-hmm. All right, Aspen, number two.
I also have Rolf and Vanellope.
Awesome, welcome.
Oh. Copycat.
It's okay, Jenny Cap. We all like the same guys.
It's all right, it's all good.
They were always like fun and interactive. Rolf didn't do much, but it was like still fun meeting him and enjoying the time. Like in Vanellope. And Vanellope was also cool too. I also discovered something new about Vanellope there.
Yeah.
Her skirt is made out of like Reese's peanut butter.
Oh, the Reese's butter wrapper? Yeah, awesome.
That's awesome.
That's cool. Good discovery.
All right, mommy. What do you got for number two?
I have Chewbacca.
Chewbacca.
Yes.
All right.
He's a fun one to interact with. I mean, he's tall. He's fuzzy. Gives good hugs.
Yes.
Chad was like so surprised because we met BB-8 first, and he saw
animatronic,
and he thought that Chewbacca would be animatronic too, and he was like, huh.
Right, he didn't know he was gonna be a real person. Though it was good.
That was really cool.
Yeah, but Chewie's always fun to meet. I mean,
he is.
I mean,
Chewie's my favorite.
Chewie's your favorite. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we always, when he come in, he gives hugs, and first time we met him, he's resting his arms right on Aspen for the picture. Kinley had the biggest smile on her face.
I got the hug with Chewie, and and my grandma like got so jealous after that. She like, I should have got that hug, not you.
Yeah, she is hilarious. That great grandma, or not great grandma, Grandma Julie. She loves Chewbacca. That's her favorite person. All right, Daddy, number two.
My number two, I'm going to make a rhyme, is Tigger and Pooh.
Oh.
You like that? I'm going to ice right here. You know. No, Tigger and Pooh, awesome.
Rebound.
Yep. Every time, they're so much fun, they're so lively. And I still go back to our Disney Moon when I got to bounce with Tigger. And, I mean, just, you know, the way they interacted with me was so much fun.
Yeah, yep, you bounce with Tigger.
But again, I mean, look at the joy Tigger and Pooh can, you know.
Right.
Yeah, and the whole group, Eeyore, Piglet, and you can meet them at Crystal Palace. You can meet them over by Winnie the Pooh ride.
It was sad not getting to see Eeyore and Piglet because the line was too long. But next time when we went, they weren't there. But like, at least I got to meet Tigger and Pooh.
Yeah.
Right. They're good. They always do bring a smile on your face. They're great ones to interact.
Yep. Very lively. Love them. So they are number two for me.
Awesome. Good one. All right, we guys ready for the big
number one.
You guys probably won't be surprised. Aurora.
What is it?
Aurora. Yeah, why did you like meeting her?
Because she's so pretty.
Okay. Well, that was a good one. And she was really sweet. That was when
I love her.
And you love her? Aw. Yeah, she was very sweet to you because when you first met her, you were only 18 months and Kinley really took to her. Her and Tinkerbell.
Yeah.
For the two characters that when she was 18 months when we took her that she actually just drew herself to. She loved them. That's cool. All right, Aspen. Drum roll.
Number one.
The Great Goofini.
Great Goofini, huh?
Nice.
All right. And I think I know why, but tell our viewers why.
He's very fun and to interact with, and the biggest reason, he's my biggest crush.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. He's a crush.
He's always been my favorite from little on. I always thought he was very goofy.
Hence the name.
Goofy.
And I'd always laugh, like, whenever he did something funny.
Okay.
So,
that's awesome.
Yeah.
All right. Ready? One. What do you got, mommy?
I have Mary Poppins.
Perfect. I knew that one.
Perfect. practically perfect in every way.
Yep.
I mean, we met her in UK in the UK Pavilion, yep, in the garden in the back. She was very fun that day. The girls were a little shy, I didn't want to meet her. Kinley was in her stroller. She came over with her little umbrella and was talking to Kinley. And we asked her to come, you know, if she'd be our nanny. She's like, she can't right now, yep, but if we ever need to, just rip up a note and put it in our fireplace.
Yep.
And then we met her again in the courtyard at Magic Kingdom. That was fun. She's, like I said, she's so interactive, so polite, so nice. And she loves reciting movie quotes.
She does. Yep.
My favorite saying is, did you say spit spot? And she just said it for me. It's great. Yeah. It's not in my face.
So really, really cool.
Spit spot.
That's definitely a really cool character meet and greet.
Yeah, well, definitely.
She is perfect. She's practically perfect in every way.
You better believe it.
But you're not.
Go down.
I'm getting there.
All right, here we go. Ready? Number one. All right, number one, no surprise to these guys here, is Elsa. Elsa's got the hots for me, so it's always fun to go and interact with her. And
I'm just going to say right now, it's the other way around. Daddy has a big crush on Elsa.
Nope, other way around. She was totally into me when we met her, so, you know, it's...
He got selfie with both.
Okay, I'll give him that.
Yeah.
Elsa did get jealous.
Yep. Oh, no, Anna got jealous. Because I took a selfie with Elsa, so then Anna got jealous.
Oh, I thought it was the other way around.
So then I had a selfie with Anna as well. So I got some selfies with the sisters.
Yeah, that's right. It was the other way around. I thought that Elsa was like, no, you got a selfie with me. But you're right, because we met Elsa.
So if there ever was a character meet and greet with Jessica Rabbit, I think that'd be, you know, up there at number one. But right now I'm going to have to go default with Elsa. So.
Which is, they are very funny.
It was. In all honesty,
they were good.
The comedy was fun. The way they went back and forth, they bantered a little bit like sisters, and they, right, you know, threw a bunch of jokes in from the movie. So the actual interaction part was fun. So
it was. I mean, when we met them in Norway, we didn't meet them this last time around, but the trip we had in 2017, mm-hmm, that's when we got all the selfies, and they were hilarious.
Yeah, it was fun.
It was a good interaction.
We met Anna first. And then Elsa saw Daddy waiting.
Yep.
And she's like, hey, you want to take a selfie?
Right.
And like, sure. And then when we were meeting Elsa, Anna saw his daddy had his phone, and he saw that he and she got a selfie. Yep. So she's like, hey, you want a selfie?
Right. It was good. That's why I love how they interact with you. Like, they, they were competing, so it was kind of funny.
Yeah, I think that was the funny part, you know. Yeah, make an old fat guy feel good for a minute. So
it was good. That was fun. They were good. I mean, they are always fun to meet.
It was a lot of fun. Yeah.
All right. Well, again, thank you for watching one of our top five.
Definitely.
Our top five character meet and greets again.
Comment below. Let us know your top five.
Or your number one or
number
anything.
One, whatever you want to do. Just comment. Let us know. Because it's always fun to get into the discussions, you know, and talk to everyone. So definitely comment, like.
Big thumbs up.
Yep, big thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe.
Yep.
Always looking for subscribers because we have a 1,000K giveaway.
And 10,000 subscribers in She Rides Tower of Terror.
Yeah, so again, 1,000K giveaway. As soon as we hit 1,000, we have a nice giveaway.
Yep.
And then when we get a little further with 10,000, she has to do Tower of Terror. So
it's like 9,999 and no more.
Well, if we make this thing go viral, we'll even do something crazier. So.
Oh boy.
Yeah.
You'll ride Rock and Roller Coaster.
Thanks. I'm just gonna exit.
Yeah. Look, before she exits, let's just say thank the Phoenicians. Don't forget to subscribe. Let us know who you like.
And subscribe as many times as you can so she rides Rock and Tower Terror.
Alright, ready?
Alright.
One, two, three. Thank the Phoenicians.